Hi there, my name's Rob McDonald, and I'm an interpreter for Santa Clara County Parks. It's my job to share the stories of our history, culture, and natural resources with our community members and visitors to our parks here in Santa Clara County. In our last video about the history of Almaden Quicksilver, we learned that after the Quicksilver Mining Company declared bankruptcy in 1910, the communities of Spanishtown and English Camp dispersed across the Bay Area, moving away from New Almaden and even going beyond. Various small mining companies eked out a living by mining the tailing piles and digging large open cuts into the sides of the hill. When the environmental bill came due, the East Coast mine owners and stockholders who had achieved their profits were long gone. This left today's citizens burdened with the cleanup of Mercury's toxic legacy.
In 1977, Santa Clara County Parks and Recreation Department opened Almaden Quicksilver County Park with the intention of creating open space where the visitors could recreate. While knowing about the mining history, the department didn't understand the full depth or complexity of cleaning up the mercury contamination. How did a landscape with so many resources extracted from it become Almaden Quicksilver County Park, a favorite recreational open space? Between 1845 through 1912, men toiled beneath the surface of the New Almaden Hills, blasting 50 miles of tunnels and digging shafts to a depth of 2,000 feet so they could bring red cinnabar ore to the surface. Roads were cut into hillsides and miles of ore car tracks were laid to take the ore down to the valley furnaces so the ore could be processed and supplies could be taken up to the shaft houses and mining camps on the hill. The rolling foothills of the Santa Cruz Mountains were stripped of thousands of oak and madrone trees to fuel the furnaces. On the steep coastal mountain slopes, ancient redwood trees were cut to create huge timbers that held up the mine tunnels. Waste rock and low-grade ore was dumped on the hillsides and grew into mountains of their own, called waste rock and tailing piles. Near the reduction works, sulfur dioxide fumes created by roasting cinnabar to produce mercury were funneled through long pipes to three chimneys. The chimneys allowed the stinky, rotten egg smell to rise above the hacienda area, but the released gases were absorbed by the atmosphere, resulting in acid rain. After cinnabar rocks were roasted, furnace waste rock called tailings were typically dumped into the creek or in more modern times used as a road base. Because the furnaces weren't 100% efficient, some mercury was trapped within the rocks. Over time, rainwater washing over the rock released mercury contaminating the land, the Guadalupe River watershed, and South San Francisco Bay, impacting wildlife and people. In the 1980s, shortly after County Parks acquired the land, the park was declared a state Superfund site requiring long-term cleanup that has lasted for decades. In the mid-1990s, County Parks funded a multi-million dollar cleanup. Crews capped the main furnace area with 3 feet of clay soil, planted vegetation, removed mine waste, and added rock along the stream banks to prevent contaminated soil from eroding into the creeks. Another remediation project removed calcined waste rock from the park roads and trails and further shored up the stream banks. Mercury contamination of local streams and lakes requires ongoing monitoring. Mercury that settles in the creek mud is absorbed by algae and converted into methyl mercury in the food chain. The algae is eaten by aquatic insects, snails, and freshwater clams, while larger fish consume the smaller creatures, moving methyl mercury up the food chain and concentrating it in larger fish and humans who might eat those fish. Fish consumption warnings along Los Alamitos Creek and the Guadalupe River should be heeded. Many bodies of water in California have fish consumption advisories because of mercury's use throughout the state. In 2012, further remediation projects were completed, including the addition of an aerator in Almaden Reservoir to prevent methyl mercury from forming. Providing safe recreational opportunities and environments is a core value of Santa Clara County Parks. The continuing remediation efforts to eradicate mercury contamination will ensure that this and future generations will enjoy a new legacy, one of vast open spaces that are home to a diversity of plants and wildlife. Join us for our next episode where we'll explore how today's visitors can contemplate New Almaden's past as we move into the future. Thank you. If you choose to come visit us at Almaden Quicksilver County Park, please bring plenty of water, sun protection, and sturdy shoes. Check the park's website and trail map for trail conditions or restrictions. If our video series sparks your interest, before visiting the New Almaden Quicksilver Mining Museum, located in the historic Casa Grande, please consult the Almaden Quicksilver Museum webpage at parkhere.org for current visiting hours.